So I'm Brett Murphy, and I'm born and bred in Collinsville, so I've been here all my life. My great-grandfather actually come here from Blair Athol. So he was a coal miner, and then every generation since have been coal miners. So yeah, May Day is something that you remember from day dot. Like when you're so little that you're getting given little ice creams out and things like that, and it all just sticks with you because it's just so exciting. And it got to the stage, of course, where I was part of the committee that run May Day for 11 years. So I mean, from coming from giving ice creams and things like that to actually running the show and doing the whole game, the whole organisations, with a great team of people, they're probably my fondest memories of Collinsville. Yeah. There's lots of things that you remember. I remember the passion play down in Gordon's allotment where the Pit Pony is now, the Pit Pony Tavern. That was a big wide open allotment. And there was a brother that come here called Brother Jeffries. And Brother Jeffries was one of these people that just loved everybody. And he used to get on the back of a truck, Heck Davies truck, with the PA system and go around town singing out to everybody that he knew, because he knew everyone in town. And he'd sing out, "Hello, Mrs. So-and-so and your little sister and your little brother," and then all that, "come to the passion play." So like driving all around town. And I mean, that was pretty exciting stuff. So what happened was, I mean, it was packed. It would have been in the early 60s. Yeah, so passion plays. School breakups were, like back in the day, were really special. You know, you had your watermelons and all that sort of stuff, and it was pretty full bore, yeah. Sue Bacon, she never taught me, but she was a stunner. She was my favourite teacher. We had so many good teachers here, and one that I've talked to today, Bev Bullock, who was Bev Norris when she first came here, and she come on, the first time I saw her, she lived in Carpet Street, which was around the corner from our place, and she come out around the corner in this little red step-through scooter with a hat on that looked like a rocket top. Without a doubt, Graham and I were friends from all the way back, all the way through school, and we're still best of friends now. I mean, there's other friends as well, but Graham, he's a lovely bloke. Of course, we wagged school, and we used to go up 40 foot up Mount Devlin, and it just had running water back in those days. Lots of water from the wet season and that sort of stuff. So there was water running out of the mountain, and it was down. And of course, no one knew you were there. You know, some days you'd take a tin of baked beans and a can opener, and you'd be up there all day. It was like, yeah, hey, good this. So yeah, good memories up that way too. It's like we built cubby houses over on the mine lease, and there was different gangs. Different groups, and the other group, of course, they were always the ones that started it, in my story. So they wrecked our cubby house, so then the next couple of days we'd do a raid on their cubby house and it'd be totally wrecked, and we're up in the trees over in the mine, you know. So there was that sort of stuff going on. Yeah, so good fun, no matter what. When you were grounded, right, then something really bad, I was grounded. And the limits were the hospital, the railway line at the station, the railway line to go to Scottville, so that bottom where the servo is there, so that you had to play in there, you're grounded.
What are the biggest changes you've seen in Collinsville, right?
Wow. Not all good. You know, I've seen the high times where the booms were on, seen the busts as well. Like most people my age or roundabout, it hasn't been fun. I mean, there was lots of fun, but there's some sad times in there as well. So boom and bust, like any mining town, but we're sort of still here. It's our place and we belong here and it's ours. So we're going to be here for a long time.